Hi, this is Bernie here again from sunny San Diego. This is my latest video about Ansel networking. So I'm going to tell you how to set up networking on your Ansel server and how to set up a static IP as well. So when I say Ansel server, that means it could be Ansel hardware. So we have three lines of hardware, the Ansel Nano, the Ansel One. So the Ansel Nano is based on the Raspberry Pi 4. Then we have the Ansel One, which is our flagship fanless desktop server. And then we have the Ansel Two line, which is the rack mount servers for, you know, powerful servers in the data center or in your server room. All right, so, but an Ansel server can also be something running on your own hardware. So if you don't go with Ansel hardware and, you know, have your own server, you can download Antman. It's running on Edge Linux, which is our own flavor of CentOS Linux. And, but it also, the VMs can run any OS, including Windows, obviously. And you can install it on your own server, so you're not bound to Ansel hardware at all. All right, so but when you have Ansel, you see we have our instant SSL technology here. So we have a secure connection, all encrypted using our instant SSL. It's a subdomain of ansel.us. So if you're running Antman, you can grab your own subdomain of ansel.us and just get started with that. Awesome. So you see the networking settings here. So this is the dashboard of my little Ansel named Daffodil, and Daffodil is my Ansel Nano. And you see the private IP, which is the local IP inside my LAN, and you see the public IP, which is, you know, the IP that this thing is accessible in the open internet. And then you see all the menu items here in the sidebar on the left-hand side. The one I'm focusing on today is the network tab here. So let's click on network and see how we can set up the networking for an Ansel server. So again, here you see the private IP and the public IP. You see the primary DNS server. In my case, I set it to the address of my router here because my router also has a DNS server and DNS cache integrated. Then you see a block here with the network interfaces. So the NICs, the network interface controllers that I have on my server. Since this is an Ansel Nano, there is only one NIC, which is called BR0. Because the Ansel Nano and the Raspberry Pi 4 that the Ansel Nano is based on, they only have one Ethernet port, and we call that BR0. But if you have an Ansel 1 or some other server, you might have more interfaces. So this photo here is from the Ansel 1, and it shows you the actual physical position of each one of the four NICs that it comes with. So it's super easy for you to tell the difference which one's BR0, BR1, and 2 and 3, because you get that graphical representation here. And you see it's enabled, so we have the check mark here, and we've set it to a static IP, and I'll show you how to do that in a minute. And here is the static IP that I set it to. Here's the MAC address of that network interface controller, and we have the netmask here. And I'll get to that in a minute. And then we have some network defaults. So we have the default gateway IP that is very important. That's the gateway that takes you out to the open internet. So if you're in a small office or home setting, that is usually just your router that provides you that gateway to the open internet. Then we tell it what network interface is the default default gateway on. So what interface should it use to get to the default gateway? In our case, we only have one, right? But remember, on other computers, you might have more NICs, more network interface servers. You have the default DNS servers here. You have the base IP for your internal Antlets network. And if you're in a corporate setting and you cannot go out to the open internet without going through a corporate proxy, then you can enter your proxy settings here. Okay, so let's go back to the actual interface, and I'm hitting edit here. So in my network interface controller, as you see, it's set to a static address, and all you need to do is select static here. So there's only two settings, static and DHCP. So we have static here. In case you do static, you need to, you know, provide the static IP that it should go to, and the netmask. So what does that mean? So usually you have a local LAN somewhere that your Ansel server is attached to. So in my case, here, this is just an office router, and the office router provides me all IP addresses 192.168.*.*, right? So I have that. It's called a /16 network, as you see here. So I have 16 bits on the right hand side here that can vary, and another 16 bits here that are constant, and that is why I specified this netmask here. So those are the 4 bytes, and if you put it to a binary representation, the 255 decimal is just 8 ones in binary, right? So you have all ones here, all ones here, and then all zeros here, and all zeros there. So now I moved something here. All right, so that just means the one that have zeros here, they can vary. Those are the 12.1, right? So all the network I can access would be 192.168.anything here in the remaining 2 bytes. So that's all you have to set up when you put it on static. You can leave it on DHCP. That's the simple setting. So then you don't have to do anything. You just set it on DHCP, and that's the default setting, right? So if you get your Ansel server, by default, it's set to DHCP, so everything will be automatic. So then the only requirement is you need a DHCP server in your LAN. And then if you run it in a small office or in your home, usually you have a DHCP server in your router. So everything will work just automatically, and your router will assign the IP address automatically. And then the Ansel will broadcast the IP address that it got assigned from your router. It will broadcast it using MDNS. So, and you can just type myansel.local in your browser to access your Antman the first time, right? Before you've set up your instant SSL, which I did here. So I can also access it with daffodil.ansel.us, which is way better than myansel.local. But, you know, when the server is new, you want to access it the first time, so you can just use myansel.local. Okay, so when you hit save configuration, so I'll put it back to static here. When you hit save configuration, that's all you need to do. And then you might worry, what if I made a mistake? What if I put the wrong network configuration and then I'm not able to access my Ansel server anymore? You know what? These things happen. They shouldn't. Normally, if you're careful with setting everything up, it won't happen. But sometimes it happens, right? So thankfully, we've thought of that case. So when you hit save configuration here and you made any changes, then it will ask you to reboot your server. So the server will reboot and then come up again. So then you log into Antman again, and Antman will ask you if everything's working and to confirm the new settings. So, but if you don't confirm the settings within 30 minutes, then automatically we will revert everything to the old network settings. So how awesome is that? You basically can't make a mistake. If you mess things up after 30 minutes, it will automatically be reverted to the old state. And, you know, just by, you know, getting back into Antman and confirming that everything works, you just cancel that reversion to the old state. So that is actually a very cool feature here. So that's all there is to the interface configuration. And you can enter your default gateway IP. So that is very important. So if you need to get out to the internet, you need to tell the system, where is my default gateway that leads me out to the open internet? And usually that's just your router's IP. And it's usually automatically set up when you use DHCP. But when you use a static IP, it cannot hurt to enter it manually so that your server knows where to turn to in order to get out to the internet. And you also need to tell it where, what interface to use in order to get to this gateway. In our case, there is only one interface, but you know, there might be more interfaces on your server, and there's four on the ANSL ones and four on the ANSL twos. So make sure you hit the right interface. And then there's the default DNS servers. So many people just use their router as the default DNS server, because most routers just have a DNS server integrated and they cache the DNS. I personally like to use the Google servers, which are 8888 and 8844. There's also OpenDNS, so if you don't like Google, you want to use the OpenDNS servers, they have their IP addresses as well. Just look it up on the internet, OpenDNS servers, and you find their IP addresses there. For the base IP, that is the first 3 bytes of our local Antlets network, and I'm going to show you that in a minute, what that means. And here, if you have a corporate proxy to get out to the internet, you can enter your proxy credentials here. Okay, so that was the network settings. So let's just get back to our Antlets list. And here we have four Antlets in this case, and you see three of them are KVM. So that means they are real VMs using KVM technology. And we also have bare metal containers using LXC technology here. And that's why we call our instances Antlets, right? Because there's no other word for naming a virtual server that can be both of two things, right? It can be a VM, but it can also be a bare metal container. And with bare metal containers, you're getting so much more out of your hardware because it has virtually zero overhead. The RAM is shared. So if you make it 1 gigabit here, 1 gigabyte of RAM here, but at the moment it's only using 1/10 of a gigabyte, then the other 0.9 gigabytes will be available for other LXC Antlets at that point in time. So it's all dynamic and shared and zero overhead, and that enables you to run tens of LXC Antlets, even 100 of them on an ANSL Nano or an ANSL One, just because our instances can be VMs or bare metal containers, right? And you don't have that on like AWS or Azure or something. Those are all VMs, and then you need a separate tool set to manage your containers. And here it's all integrated and unified. All right, and then you see the IP addresses here. So you see they all start in 10.1.1. So that is the Antlets subnet that I talked about earlier. And here's the reason why we have that. ANSL is all about on-prem hosting, right? So if you're on-prem, you don't have unlimited IP addresses. Usually if you're in a small office or in a home setting, you only have one public IP address, right? So now if you have four Antlets, they cannot have their own public IP address because, you know, you're with some internet service provider in your on-prem location, and they just gave you one IP address. So it all needs to be multiplexed. And we help you do that by putting your Antlets in an internal subnet 10.1.1, and you can change that 10.1.1 in the network settings, as you've seen. But 10.1.1 usually is a nice default. And then all the Antlets live in that Antlet subnet. And then we can multiplex these Antlets here to the open internet based on domain names, right? So you can do that with our instant SSL. So daffodil.ansel.us would be the whole ANSL. But if you use bunt.daffodil.ansel.us, then you would be able to access this specific Antlet here based on the domain name. But all four are multiplexed to that just one IP address that you have in your office or in your home. All right, so this was my little video about ANSL networking setup. I hope you liked it. Please make sure to subscribe to our channel to get access to more videos like these. And don't forget to hit the like button. It really helps us to spread the word. And see you again soon. Bye.